When I first heard of this story, I was completely freaked out. I truly wouldn't know what to do if I was in that situation. But before I get into the story, if you're a fan of monsters, scary stories, and lore, this is the channel for you. Please hit the like button by flicking it. Please subscribe. Now let's get into today's video. The year is 1970 at an undisclosed Marine base. Someone calls in saying that there's two Marines that are super sick, and if someone doesn't come and help, they are not going to make it. So on call that night is Medical Officer John Likens, and he goes to see those two Marines, except there's a Category 2 hurricane going on, and those winds are going anywhere from 95 miles per hour to about 100 miles per hour. So when he says it's bad, it was truly bad. So John books it, and because there's a hurricane, there's no jeeps, no ambulances, and pretty much everyone else is gone. So it's really just him alone. Wanting to be a good Marine and wanting to help his two comrades, he goes anyways. But he's a rookie corpsman, so when he gets there, he truly doesn't know what to do. But he knows that they're hurt enough that they cannot take those two Marines anywhere. They both had flu-like symptoms and were vomiting quite a bit. You really didn't have to be a doctor to see that these two Marines were sick. So what John wants to do is just stabilize them enough so they can get to a better hospital after the hurricane passes. But the storm keeps coming and getting worse and worse. It gets to the point that John is wondering if these barricades are going to be able to hold up. He finally stabilizes the Marines, and all he has to do now is just wait out the storm. So with all the adrenaline gone, John gets very tired, so he decides to take a nap, since there's really nothing much he could do. So he lays down, and while the hurricane's going on, he really can't get any sleep. And then he hears a tick, bang, tick, tick, bang. And he kind of pauses for a little bit. He gets up to go see what it is. And when he looks outside, he sees this huge tree just banging against the window. Just tick, bang, tick, bang. At that same time, John feels something going through the room. So he looks around to see what it is, and there's nothing there. And he gets a bad feeling that something bad is going to happen, but not from the storm, from something else. He just doesn't know what it is. But he thinks maybe he's just being weird, so he lays down and tries to take a nap. But that feeling he has does not go away, no matter what he does. So he sleeps with one eye open. And finally, after some time, he starts to drift away. And right when he's drifting away, he hears someone else in the room. He opens his eyes fully and looks around the room, and that's when he sees another Marine standing right next to his bed. He looks at the Marine, and the Marine says, "I'm Major Anderson." So John gets up as fast as he can and stands at attention. The Major says, "That tree is starting to hit really hard. We need to move your patients now." So they both start to move the patients, and right when they're moving them, they hear the tree start to crack. So they both move the patients to a safe area, and right after they do, there's a big smash. That tree just went through the window and the wall. It landed right where John was sleeping, and on one of the beds a patient was sleeping on as well. John has no doubt that that tree would have killed both of them. So John turns to see the Major, and the Major is gone. So he starts to yell his name, and there's no response. So now John is worried that the Major went outside and might be hurt. So he puts an alert out to the military police. As night becomes morning, the storm is finally done, and the military police are able to get there. But before they leave, John wants to give his patients just one last check. So while he's checking them, John casually says, "How was it having a Major come and check on you?" And the man kind of looks at him a bit puzzled. And John says, "Yeah, it's not every day that you get to hang out with a Major." The patient, still kind of baffled, says, "Sir, I don't know what you mean." And John says, "Yeah, Major Anderson was here. He was checking in on you." And the patient says, "Who is Major Anderson?" Now John is starting to get a little freaked out, and he tells the man, "Yeah, he put the IV on you. Him and me carried you out." And the guy's like, "Sir, I don't know what you mean. All we heard was you last night jibber-jabbing." John at this point is like, "No, this guy's confused. Let me go talk to the other patient. I'm sure he saw what happened." So he goes to the other patient and asks him the same thing. "Hey, did you see Major Anderson last night?" And that patient says, "No, who is that, sir?" John is like, "The Major. He literally carried you out of here." And the patient's like, Sir, I don't know what you're talking about. At this point, it's clear. No one else saw Major Anderson except John. But he's like, no, I'm not going crazy. Let me go ask the police. I'm sure the military police have to know everyone that's left on the base. So John goes and asks the military police, and they say the same thing. There's no one by that name here. John cannot believe it. He says, yes, there is. He's in headquarters. The military police look at each other and say, sir, headquarters left a long time ago. And now John's like, these people are gonna think I'm crazy. I know he was here. I shook his hand. They're just mistaken. They just have to be mistaken. The very next day, John goes to headquarters base to ask the person in charge if there's a Major Anderson that works there. And the person in charge says, no, there's not a Major Anderson that works here. And he's confused and he's upset. And the sergeant looks at him and says, hey, why don't you follow me back here? She calmly walks into a back room, and then she stops and points at a picture and asks John, is that who you're talking about? He looks at the picture and he says, yes, that is Major Anderson. She looks at him super puzzled and says, sir, he died a few years back in the Vietnam War. John turns white as a ghost, and he realizes at that moment that he had shook a dead man's hand. Till this day, he says that there's no rational explanation for that, except that it was from another world. That was today's story. Tell me what you guys think in the comments. What did John really see that night? And if you like this type of content, please subscribe and follow me on any of my platforms. And if you do already, from the bottom of my heart, I truly thank you. And remember, sometimes what the world needs is not a hero. What it really needs is a monster.